the proud, but it gives more grace to the humble. When you are humble enough to admit, yes, of course I have sinned. We've all broken God's commandments. We've all lied. We've all cheated. We've all done things that are wrong. And the wages of these sins are death. But the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Christ died on the cross. He shed his blood for the forgiveness of all our sins. He was buried and rose again on the third day, that if you shall confess with your mouth the Lord Jesus and shall believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. That's the only requirement for you to be saved and for your name to be written in heaven. Go to Jesus. It doesn't matter what you have done. He will receive each and every one of you when you go to him in truth. Go to Jesus. He loves you. For God did not send his son Jesus into the world to condemn the world, but that the world through Jesus might be saved. Go to Jesus. The hour is late. The night is far spent. Jesus is coming. Lay hold of your salvation.
Hallelujah. We are in the last days. We are in the last days. God is warning the whole world. He sent his word to the whole world, to the sinners as we are. We are all sinners. But are you ready to change your mind? Are you ready to repent for your sin? God needs the ready heart, those ready to humble their heart to repent for their sin. Remove your pride. Remove your pride before it gets too late. You hear the voice of the Lord. You hear the word of the Lord. You cannot deny that God sent his word to you. The day of judgment, you are responsible for being stubborn.
Jesus Christ said, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd gave his life for the sheep on the cross. The Bible says that we've all broken God's commandments. We've all sinned, and the wages of sin is death. For the gift of God is everlasting life through Jesus Christ. Go to Jesus. He loves you. He's not willing that you spend eternity in hell. Do not wait until you are in hell before you realize how real it is. Jesus wants you in heaven, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. The thief, Satan, comes not but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. But Jesus Christ has come that we might have life, or that we might have it more abundantly. He is the good shepherd. The good shepherd has come to seek and to save that which was lost. The devil, Satan, has come to bewitch you, to tell you that God is not real, that you mustn't listen to God. But if you ignore the very one who made you your Father in heaven and what he did for you on the cross, you will not see heaven, but you will see how hell is out of darkness, where there is weeping, where there is wailing and gnashing of teeth. Go to Jesus, lay hold of your salvation. He loves you. He's given you free will. He's not willing that you should perish. But he said, unless you repent and change your mind from your unbelief and believe on the Son of God, you will perish. Lay hold of your salvation. Time is short. Jesus is coming.
Hallelujah. Bible said in the Old Testament, in the book of Genesis, that's what the Old Testament, when the whole
And you will be saved. God bless you.